How is it going, guys? And today is a great day. Today we're getting some new shoes for the Mustang. So you don't know how many times I've been roasted for these wheels that I have on my car. They are FR500 wheels from American Muscle. They're not authentic, I believe they're just the American Muscle wraps. I got them a few years back, and it's time for some new wheels, okay? These are like the Payless shoes of wheels. They're good looking wheels, in my opinion. They're a little bit outdated. If they were all black or all some other color, you know, just one solid color, I think they would look a lot better. But with the machined lip, they do just end up looking a little bit on the cheaper side. So today we're gonna go ahead and take these off and we're gonna throw on some new wheels. Now I haven't gone and got the wheels yet, so we still have to go do that. And then I have to take it to a tire shop and have them mount the same rubber I have on right now to the new wheels. And then we will toss them on and we will compare the two. These wheels, like I said, they're fine. They do the job, but they're just a little bit out of style. So I'm going with something a little bit more updated, something that I think will look a bit better with the current setup I have right now, and something that will stand the test of time when it comes to durability and looks. These, if I go and dip my car or wrap my car, they might not match. The silver lip kind of just doesn't float with everything. It kind of works with this color since I have the gray and the chrome badges and stuff like that. It kind of works, but at the end of the day, it's time for something new. They look fine, but we need something new. The wheels I ended up going with were ESR Forged RF1s. They look a lot similar to Forged Line F14s, which is kind of the style I wanted to go with. They're forged wheels, they're gonna be durable, they're gonna be lightweight, and overall they're gonna look good. My original plan for this car was to eventually get some TE37s for it because I think that would look sick. You don't see too many Mustangs with TE37s, but the only issue is those shits are fucking expensive. If any of you have looked into TE37s, you know a pair of them is gonna cost you anywhere between $3,000 to $6,000. It just depends on what you get, what type of TE37. There's a whole lot of different things that go into pricing with TE37s, so I was like, you know what? I don't feel like dumping $4,000 into this car just for wheels. I'd rather go out and buy a different car anyways later this year. So we're gonna hold off on that. So I went and I looked at my options. I was looking at the Forged Star F14s. Those I liked a lot. And then my buddy hit me up and he said that he had the hookup for ESRs. So I went and talked to them and they decided to hook me up. And these are some great looking wheels. Now I haven't seen them in person, but in pictures, I mean, they look beautiful. Like I said, they look like pretty much exactly what I'm looking for. They have a nice deep concave. That's exactly what I like when it comes to wheels. I like a deep concave or a fat lip. That's just me. But when I get them, when I feel them, when I touch them, I'll be able to actually tell the quality and I'll be able to see if they're worth it. So at the end of the day, we'll be able to compare the two. We'll be able to see the cheap American Muscle FR500 reps compared to ESR forged wheels. Personally, I don't have anything against reps. It all just depends on your budget and what you feel like doing. TE37s, like I said, are super expensive. So if someone were to buy reps for a car similar to this, I don't think it'd be that big of an issue. But it all just depends. I mean, you can't put rep TE37s on like a GTR or something like that. That'd be ridiculous. So it all just depends on your budget and what car you have. But for these reps, I mean, so far they've held up really well. I put a lot of power through them. I've won a lot of races on them and they've done the job. They've done their course. It's time to retire them. So let's go ahead. Let's hop in the Mustang. Let's go get some new wheels. First though, we got to listen to her. It won't be a cold start because I had to drive to my parents anyways, but we can hear that beautiful exhaust note. I also apologize if the exterior of my car is dirty. It's been raining nonstop, so no point in washing it, and it's going to continue raining. Luckily today is sunny. All right, guys, a few hours later and we're back. It just stopped raining, so I'm gonna try to record this before the rain comes in. It looks like we'll have a nice, beautiful day for the rest of the day, but who knows? The weather has been dog shit. I went to ESR and picked up the wheels and the people there were super nice. It was really quick and clean. I ended up changing the color. I went from a hyper black to a satin black. They did discontinue the hyper black, that is why, so I mean, makes sense. The media guy actually recognized me too when I was chatting with him for a bit. It's really cool talking to you guys and seeing the support you guys give me. It's really nice and I appreciate it so much. But anyways, let's go ahead and let's take a look at the new wheels. As you can see, we have the satin black RF1s from ESR, and they look super similar to the ForgeStar F14s. I went with these because the people at ESR were willing to help me out, and I can't thank them enough. I mean, they look absolutely beautiful. Look at that. This is exactly what I wanted. A nice deep concave on the rear. Ooh. And then up front too, we have a slightly less concave, but still, nevertheless, a concave. And I'm just a huge fan of that style. I like it when they have a lip like my old wheels, but the concave, I think, beats it out. And they also just have that really thick look. These are 18 by 10.5 with plus 22 offset in the rear, and then 18 and 9.5 plus 22 offset up front. So the rear's super thick. I have a 305 Mickey Thompson ET Street Art on the rear, and it just really fills up the whole wheel well. I'm sorry my car is dirty. If it wasn't gonna rain some more, I would wash it, but it's still gonna rain. But look at that. I mean, just the shimmer on it, just beautiful. And this is after driving in the rain too. I mean, it's just still looking super nice right there. And then up front, same thing. We have the 18 by 9.5 plus 22s, and they just look super nice. Nitto's NT555 G2s up front, really filling the wheel well too. The rears, obviously, the slicks are gonna be a bit thicker, but up front too with the street tires, and it just looks really nice. So what we have to do now, I didn't expect them to be this thick, but what we have to do now is actually grind away a little bit because it's right up to the edge. I've done it in the past. I've grinded away at it in the past, but we have to do it a little bit more because these wheels are just super thick in the rear too. I mean, look at that. Look at how thick that is. That's one thick son of a bitch right there, if I do say so myself. God, man, it's just stupid thick. Look at that. Goddamn, boy, you thick. I'm honestly smiling so much. I can't be happier with these. Honestly, I couldn't be any happier. It's just, it's exactly what I was looking for. Perfect look. Looks like I'm ready to go gap some Chevys and some Dodges. I know that's gonna stir up some comments, but yeah, I mean, it's just, it's a beautiful looking wheel setup. I'm at a loss of words for how good it looks. I couldn't be any happier with the way it came out. And I wish I could clean my car. I might wash it. I might wash it really quick and see and go from there. But as is right now, I'm super happy. All right, let me go ahead and pull the wheels off the car, and we're gonna start grinding out that wheel well. I don't know if I'm gonna run the mini spacer up front to fill it in a little bit more. I don't know. I'll have to try it out and see, but let's get started. All right, guys, got the wheel off. Look at that. It's just a bowl of oatmeal right there. Look at that. Anyways, I grinded away a little bit up in here. I don't know how well you guys are gonna be able to see it. That doesn't really matter. I'm gonna come back another day and finish it up because I keep burning my face. The hot metal just keeps falling on me, and I'm gonna not take any more of that. So I need to buy a face shield and a bunch of other stuff. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and toss the wheels back on. I'm gonna lower it back down. It is really dirty right now. I do wanna see how the car will look really clean. And the wheels are a bit dirty too. Again, we were driving in the rain, but I mean, look at that. It's just perfect.
All right, guys, it's the next day. I know I said I was gonna wrap it up yesterday, but I still have some stuff I wanna do. We have to start grinding away the wheel well even more. It is just cutting into the tire, and we gotta stop that.
So if you look right here, it is just really cutting into it. So we gotta stop that. What's happening pretty much is the offset of the wheel is poking out a little bit more than my old wheels. I've trimmed away in here before, but we gotta trim away even more and more and more and just get it to stop because I don't want it cutting into my tire. These wheels though, in the morning, ooh, they look beautiful.
So anyway, let me pop off the wheels again and then we will be able to start getting to work.
All right, guys, a couple hours later and I think I got it trimmed away. I just really went to town. Obviously, I have the fender flare, so it's covering up this nasty mess. I hope this is enough. If not, I'm gonna have to come back under here and do it some more. I pretty much grinded it out and tapped it outwards with a hammer, so hopefully it clears it. We'll have to see. Only time will tell. So now I'm gonna go ahead and spray some paint over this so it doesn't rust, and then I'll start on the other side. So I'll just do this off camera and I'll see you guys after. All right, guys, I'm finally done cutting. I mean, I chopped out a lot of material. Like, look at all this metal just laying around. We got more on the other side too. I mean, there's just metal bits and pieces everywhere. We chopped out a lot. The primer is drying up in there. We gotta coat that so it doesn't rust. But I'm gonna go ahead and start washing the car. I said I was gonna wash it yesterday, but I knew I had to cut more anyways. So I'm gonna just put you guys up on a tripod, wash the car while it's up so I can get all the metal out of there, and then we'll be good to go. While the paint is drying on the car, I just want to demonstrate the weight difference between a radial forged wheel, just like the ESR RF1 you see here, and a cheap cast wheel from American Muscle. So keep in mind, this wheel has a tire on it, but look it, with this wheel, if I try to lift it from here, it's fighting me. It is heavy. I'm picking it up,
but I can only pick up part of it. I can't pick up the whole wheel. I'm only leaning part of the box. I can't pick it up. And I'm trying. With this, with a tire on, I can go up next to it and easily lift it off the ground and bounce it if I really want to. It's a lot easier to pick up a forged wheel. They're a lot lighter and a lot stronger compared to a cheap cast wheel. Now I'm all dirty. You could see how bad I was rubbing. Looks like I made some new tread. I made my own little tread cutouts. Oh God.
And so if you can imagine all that weight you're saving shed off a rotational mass, you're actually adding horsepower. So the lighter the wheel, the better for your car. Not only is my shit gonna be stronger if anything happens, but I will technically be slightly faster than me with my cast wheels, which is always nice.
Alright guys, finished result, all said and done, nice and clean, and look at that sheen. I think that's gonna be my new catchphrase. I got them all cleaned up. I'm not the best at cleaning wheels, but these cleaned up really easily. The matte black for sure helps, and I just think they look absolutely bitchin' on the car. Just compliments the car in so many ways. The old wheels were a bit more of an old style. These are a lot more modern, and I think they just really make the car pop. It's getting a bit windy, so I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this video.
The wind was getting a bit out of control, so I wanted to wrap it up at home. That way you guys can hear me nice and clear. But I want to start out by giving a huge thank you to ESR Wheels. They really helped me out a lot on this. Car parts are expensive, and when you're buying it all on your own, it's really nice to have a sponsor come along and help you out. It's really nice, and again, I want to thank ESR Wheels so much. I will link their website down in the description down below. Also, a big thank you to Armando. Thank you, man. Couldn't thank you enough. The wheels look absolutely beautiful. I love them, and I can't wait to go racing on them. Anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a thumbs up. Comment down below what you think about the wheels. I love them. I don't care if you guys hate them. I love them. So let me know down in the comments. Subscribe to see more videos like this one. And until next video, peace.